Hello, this is Nicole, and this week I'm actually coming to you live from a different house. I'm at my partner's house this week for some holidays from my bus driving job. And anyways, so I decided I wasn't available last week with everything that was going on. I didn't have a chance to get to the Q&A, and it is a long drive to get here. So I just kind of decided to give the Q&A a rest till this morning. So here I am. So to get on to what I'm speaking about, I've referred to it a little bit last week, and for me, I'm speaking about what happens after invisible abuse and how to deal with it with nature's help. That's what I'm talking about. Hello, there's somebody there. Hi, Joni, how are you? Thank you for being here with me. Anyways, and to me, often a lot of people have asked me, well, like, what are you talking about, the invisible abuse? And oftentimes with the groups that I've been part of, or a lot of the time they talk about how to identify abuse and so on and so forth. And that is not at all what I'm talking about. For me, it's all about the person, all about the mostly women that have lived through abuse and how to step into your life as you are today. We're not, this is not about the exes. This is not about what has happened and what we went through and so on and so forth. Each one of us have gone through our own journey with abuse, and it has left us with scars. And that is where I come in with speaking about abuse from how to empower ourselves, how to integrate it into who we are so that we can grow, so that we can move forward with our lives, and integrate what has been part of our lives. And I have found that nature is the best teacher, the best mentor, the best way to learn to integrate the scars that have been part of our lives once we've suffered invisible abuse. Of course, I could use it for so many different ways, but because of so oftentimes we fall into this judgment of ourselves. We fall into this. We become our own abusers. We become very hard on ourselves. We become so that's where nature can help us. That's where nature can show us how to be kinder with ourselves, how to be ourselves, and accept that we have gone through some hard shit. We've gone through some stuff that has left us deep scars, but nature shows us how we can grow with those scars. Hi, Cynthia, how are you? And well, I'm hoping, Joni, I thank you so much. I hope it really is, because it's something I've often found that when people speak about abuse, they often speak of what they've gone through, of what the other person has done. And for me, it's like I know what I've been through. I don't need to speak about it and keep rehashing it up. It's there. And that's for other people. If you want to speak about that, there's nothing wrong with that. But that's not with me. I want to speak about where we are today and how to pick up from where we are, as damaged as we feel, as hurt as we are, as scarred. And hi, Renette. And that's where I'm hoping that the people that will connect with me is they're not going to want to talk about what they've gone through, which is part of what we have to talk about, of course. But what we've gone through from a point of how do I pick up from it now? Where right now I feel like shit, or I feel empowered, or I feel like there's all these emotions that we go through once we've gone through invisible abuse. There's all this thing, these internal things that we have to deal with when we want to move forward from abuse in our lives, from invisible abuse in our lives. And that's what I want to talk about the person. I want to talk about the, and I hate to talk about it as a victim of abuse, but that's what it is. We've gone through abuse, and we have felt, oftentimes we have felt like victims. We have felt, and I often used to say when I was going through it, I had a big V on my forehead that just kind of, and I went from being a victim to feeling like a victim to treating myself as a victim, and until I got to the point where it was more about, okay, how do I grow from here? How do I grow from here? And that's where nature becomes that amazing teacher on how to empower ourselves, on how to keep growing when we have, because nature has definitely gone through so much shit, so much. And yes, I speak like that. This is who I am. And it's not... I don't want to hide behind anything anymore. This is, and nature never does either. Nature always comes as she is. She comes with the rot, with the growth, the yeast that's growing on the trees that are rotting. There's all kinds of things happening in nature, but it shows us that it can grow from where it is. And that's what my work is all about, is bringing that part of us that has been hurt, that has been damaged, that has been, but it hasn't been damaged beyond repair. And that's where nature comes in, shows us how we can grow from where we've been damaged and where we've been scarred and where we've been, and we can bring that together and learn to grow as a whole. And so that's, as long as we are a victim, we are disempowered. Yes, exactly, Renette. And it's so true. And that's where nature tells us. That's what nature shows us, is if we keep beating up ourselves, there's no possible way of growing. There's no possible way of transforming what we've gone through into an empowerment of what we've gone through. And there's diamonds. There's so much strength that can be discovered in what we've gone through about ourselves. And when you look to nature, if you look at just a flood, there's a flood happening in an area and it's devastated the whole area. And then all of a sudden in with some time, all of a sudden the something just fell on the floor here, but all of a sudden with time, the bed of water where the stream, where the river was, or where the water raised, it transforms the water. How do you call that? Where the water was going in, it got bigger or it got smaller or it transformed. But there's trees that have fallen, there's devastation, but all of a sudden there's other life that can live there that wasn't there before. And there's other things that can take place as we go through these scars as we learn to integrate these scars, heal them, of course, discover what's to be pulled out from these scars. How can I heal this scar so that I can integrate it into who I am, so that I can grow from it? So yes, nature also allows that's Renette that wrote this. Nature also always shows us that underlying universal laws governing creation. Yes. Yes, yes, yes. I always say, oh my God, that's beautiful. Because I always say, for me, nature is a living example of the universal soul. It's like it's a physical expression of what the universal soul is, of what when I don't speak from any woo-woo airy-fairy type of thing, but for me, nature is a living physical example of what God, divine, source, and that inner part of ourselves that goes beyond our physical matter. That's what nature is, and that's why for me nature is such an amazing teacher. And thank you so much, Renette. That's why nature, because that was one of the questions I get asked, why do you use nature? I use nature as examples. I have done workshops where I bring people in nature, but when I'm teaching online, I just use nature as an example so that people can get an image of what it looks like, so that they can let go of that judgment that we have of ourselves as we're going through healing, so that we can actually move forward. So that when you're working and it is work, it is a transformation, it is a journey. When you're going through this transformation of healing from the scars of abuse, there's so much. And when we have an image, when we know what that looks like, it serves as an inspiration for, oh my God, it does live, it does exist. And it allows us to give a bit of distance to our emotions, so that we can see what it looks like and just kind of slowly detach from the emotions that we go through. And with time, build ourselves up so that the emotions don't lead us. Our strength becomes our leading force rather than our emotions, because our emotions are part of the journey. There's so much emotions as we go through the journey when we've gone through abuse. So that's kind of why nature is such a great teacher. But and another question that I often get asked is, yeah, but I don't have access to nature the way that you do. And I always tell people, if you like nature, don't worry. Just if nature is a flower on your table, if nature is just you opening a window in your high rise, or you're in the middle of New York and you can look up at the sky, and that to you is nature. Nature is what you make it out to be. The way I define nature is the way that I define nature. It's what nourishes my soul, what nourishes me. That's what nature is. I use the examples that I can identify with, but if you can identify with them in a different way in your life, it's your way of doing it. Nature is there for everybody in their own way, and that's how nature can help us to heal and grow and keep discovering and emerge into who we are, and transform the pain and the scars from abuse so that we can grow from it. So the genius of Walter Russell considered nature to be his teacher. It was also his inspiration. Who is Walter Russell? I've never heard that name before, Renette. This is a completely new name to me. Even the air we breathe, exactly. And nature is nature, and just never, ever let it be defined in a different way than what you want it to be defined for yourself. So on that, this got a bit longer because it is Q&A, and I'm surprised I went through all my Q&As, and if you had any questions, I think I responded to them as I went. What an amazing challenge, and thank you so much, Renette, for being there. And who else was there? I'm trying to see. I think I had Joni, I had Cynthia, and whoever else showed up, thank you so much. I learned so much, although I've been doing live for quite a while. This has definitely been a joy to learn how to use live on my computer. So on that, I'll wish you a great week, and I'll definitely go in and pop in and watch your other lives for the others that have gone there. So thank you, Renette, and I look forward to seeing you in our groups. Bye for now.